know you got to have your rest. She says, come lay beside me, I've been waiting since you left.
We are gathered here today to celebrate marriage. However, it is a contract not to be entered into lightly, rather entered into thoughtfully and seriously with a deep realization of its obligations and responsibilities. So as your journey begins together today as husband and wife, I just ask that you always treat one another with the greatest and utmost respect. And when times are difficult, remind yourselves of what it is that brought the two of you together in love in the first place. And then, of course, remember this moment, this day, your wedding day, in the chapel where the hangover was filmed on Las Vegas Boulevard. Yeah, that's the giggle I'm hoping for. It's going to seem like an absurd question, because it's very evident what we're here to do, but the state wants to make sure that you were not clubbed to be here, Joe. So, Joe, do you take Maggie to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, to love, honor, and cherish her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others for as long as you both shall live?
Okay.
And Maggie's saying we want to make sure you aren't clubbed over the head either. So, Maggie, do you take Joe to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, to love, honor, and cherish him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
I kind of figured she was going to say that, right? I'm glad you did too. I don't know what I would have done, actually. May we have the rings, please? All right. Each of you, you'll take it, Joe's obviously, okay? And take just a moment to reflect upon the rings. The rings are an unbroken circle. They represent unending love. For as often as the two of you will place your eyes upon these rings, or any other rings that you introduce while on your marital journey, yeah, I don't leave loopholes, may you be reminded that as of today, in just a moment actually, you are indeed solidifying a lifelong commitment to one another. And of course, the true love never fails. Joe, when you're ready, you'll just place the ring right on her finger and repeat after me. Maggie, I give you this ring.
Maggie, I give you this ring.
As a token of my love and appreciation.
As a token of my love and appreciation.
And I give this ring with a promise.
And I give this ring with a promise.
I promise to continue loving you.
I promise to continue loving you.
Honoring you.
Honoring you.
And cherishing you.
And cherishing you.
All the remaining days of my life. Joe, I give you this ring.
Joe, I give you this ring.
As a token of my love and appreciation.
As a token of my love and appreciation.
And I also give this ring with a promise.
And I also give this ring with a promise.
I promise to continue loving you.
I promise to continue loving you.
Honoring you.
Honoring you.
And cherishing you.
And cherishing you.
All the remaining days of my life.
All the remaining days of my life.
So, So this is the part in the ceremony where typically I think a minister should give some sort of advice or maybe words of wisdom, but I don't do either. And that is because I am very certain that the two of you have had more advice than you can handle in a lifetime, and you don't need any from some random woman in Vegas. Furthermore, it's overrated. None of us knew what we were doing. We all went into it with a leap of faith, right? So I don't think anybody should be giving advice. But I do want to give well wishes. I wish for you, of course, that you'll have a long, healthy, blessed, and loving life and marriage together. And I want to take just a moment to express my appreciation to for affording me the opportunity to be a part of not just your evening or your day, your wedding day, but even more so and more importantly, your journey. I'm deeply touched, and I mean that from the bottom of my heart. And I'll tell you a story as to why afterwards. But I do mean that. And I think that any minister who says it means it, but I mean it from a different place. So sincerely, I am so pleased. I'm going to put all this down so I can clap with everybody. All right. Okay. Ready for the grand finale?
Yes.
All right, then. By the power vested in me by the great state of Nevada, it truly is my honor and my privilege to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
Yay. Another kiss. One more kiss for me right there.
He unmuted himself.
She has correct?
Yes. Washington. Sorry.
Washington. May I introduce you for the very first time, taking their first steps as husband, wife, Mr. and Mrs. Washington!
Bright light city, gonna set my soul, gonna set my soul on fire. Got a whole lot of money that's ready to burn, so get those stakes up higher. There's a thousand pretty women waiting out there. They're all living the devil may care, and I'm just a devil with love to spare. So Viva Las Vegas, Viva Las Vegas. How I wish that there were more than 24 hours in the day. Even if there were 40 more, I wouldn't sleep a minute away. Oh, there's blackjack and poker and the roulette wheel, a fortune won and lost on every deal. All you need is a strong heart and a nerve of steel. Viva Las Vegas! Viva Las Vegas! Viva Las Vegas with your neon flashing and your one-armed bandits crashing all those hopes down the drain. Viva Las Vegas turning day into nighttime, turning night into daytime. If you see it once, you'll never be the same again. I'm gonna keep on the